If a toddler had the mind of an adult, she would never learn to walk. She would fall two or three times, maybe four. And then she'd say, "This really isn't for me, eh? I'm no good at this. It's not my thing." Think about it. Put your mind back into yourself when you were learning to walk. How would that be? What kind of conversations would you be having with yourself as you fell down again and again and again? But the children don't have those conversations. There's just the effort to walk, and they fall, and the effort to walk again until eventually they're walking, you know, as naturally as walking. In the first few years of our lives, we're very comfortable with uncertainty. In fact, it's all we know. Everything is uncertain. We have no problem with it. It's how we learn. We're fully in tune with life and the way things are around us. You know, when we're hungry or in pain, we cry. When we poo on ourselves, we scream. We're in the moment. We experiment. We learn. It's only later that we try to create certainty. Exhausted parents tell us, "It's because I said so." School teachers tell us, "It's because the books say so." Our friends, our peers tell us, "It's because the teachers and our parents said so." And we begin to create an identity that shelters us. We begin to select what is and isn't okay, what's right and wrong, what's good and bad, what is certain and uncertain. And we start to think into these boxes that we build ourselves. This is our personality, how we protect ourselves from uncertainty. The great news about that is uncertainty is not something to be survived or dealt with. Uncertainty is to be embraced with open arms as the greatest opportunity that exists. Uncertainty is the source of the deepest and most important freedom that any of us will ever experience. Total creative genius.